I can't tell at all, and not in the good way. Zero coverage, but... Hey guys, today on Alt Beauty Spot, where it's all things clean, colorful, fun, edgy, I am doing this fun cut crease as inspired by Nikki Makeup. Join along, watch, enjoy some clean products that hopefully perform well and achieve this beautiful look. Thanks for being here. Click subscribe and like if you so desire, and go see the professionally photographed ones on Instagram at Alt Beauty Spot. Thank you for joining. We are going to do a blue cut crease tutorial today. I've got some new products from Target yesterday as well, and I'm gonna be using some of those. One of them is the Zuzu Luxe dual powder foundation. I've had a very hard time finding powder foundations with clean beauty. And then also the Honest Beauty Extra Length Mascara and Primer. Picked this up at Target. Really excited to try this. And the Zuzu Luxe White Eyeliner. And I also went to Ulta and got some Bare Minerals lipstick, and I think I'm gonna try this color with the look. It's their long wear lipstick in color Peony. So very excited to use this as well. I got D17, which seemed like it was one of the darker ones, but just holding it up to my skin, I think it's the right color for me. It's very matte, it does not have any like sparkle in it. Let's just see how this goes. It just doesn't really feel like there's anything on my face right now. Or like, it doesn't look like there's anything on my face. Seriously, like, even though I'm putting this on, and I mean, like, I'm getting a good amount on my brush, and then I go to put it on, and I just, like, honestly, it doesn't feel like I have it. Like, it doesn't look like anything's on my face. Like, I can't tell at all, and not in the good way. Like, it's not doing anything for my complexion. It's not evening me out. It's giving me zero coverage, but I said I was gonna use it, so let's just go ahead. This formula is so transparent, like, it's insane, guys. I would say that this is definitely more of like a powder to put on stuff than a good foundation. I mean, it's just not covering anything, and I feel like I am plastering my face with this powder right now. And also, I think it's just, like, reflecting light like crazy, too. I'm whitened out right now. I don't know. I'm not super impressed with that so far. I like powder foundations. I think they're a lot easier to use, but only if they, like, actually help even out your skin and, like, cover it up. This one didn't really do so, so maybe on another day I'll try it as, like, a pressed powder. As a foundation, I'm like less than impressed by that. So yeah, bust, not loving that. Moving along, I'm very toward the very end of my Au Naturel cream concealer. I just love it though, it's so easy to use. I was using the back end of my EcoTools blurring brush and kind of scraping a little bit off, patting it where I need to, and now I'll use the actual brush to spread it and buff it out. Okay, I feel like this powder is just gonna like set into everything. now that that's on, I will move into a blush, and I think I'm gonna go with my Lily Lolo Burst Your Bubble Pressed Powder Blush. Just enough to add like a touch of flush to my face. A highlighter, my only powder highlighter I have right now is the Anika Baked Mineral Illuminizer, and I have it in Dewdrop, but I adore this. Like, this is probably my favorite highlighter that I have. I like using this fan brush because it's not very stiff. So if you want just that perfect little bit of like a flush without going overboard, it just gives you this nice little bit of like shimmer. Without creating like a streak across your face. Now, I think we will move into the eyes. I'm a little anxious about this, but laying in bed this morning, I watched Nikki Makeup do it, like a cut crease like this, but the kind where you create it and work up and then fill in the lid and you don't like cover everything and have to conceal it all over. And it was just very intriguing to me. As long as you get the shape and the technique down, it seems like it would be a much more comfortable cut crease to like potentially wear all day. I guess I'm gonna do with my Gabrielle Cosmetics eyeliner in Navy. I will create the shape and buff it out and then kind of pack that in with a touch of shadow and then go in on my lid with some lighter tones and colors. I love these Gabrielle liners because they go on very easily but are very buildable. Matching shapes is so tricky. Okay, my peeps, I think that's about as close as we're gonna get. And then now I'm going to take the Eco Tools liner smudger. Hey, fitting. And you're gonna kind of like start just pulling that line up a touch. You don't wanna go like down too much. You wanna keep that crisp under edge, but just start kind of pulling it up and like buffing it out. Do you see, this is the buffed out one, and then that's the lined one, and just how you create this nice like halo effect. I think I'm gonna take Starry Night just cause it's a bit softer, and then do Midnight as like my, just creating that crisper line in there. I'm gonna take a really stiff, dense, short little brush. This is an e.l.f., it's called a smudge brush. And this is why I keep Q-tips handy. It got a little below the line I had drawn. Okay, now that I have that nice and like pressed in there, it's a short round brush. It's like medium stiffness. It's not super stiff, but it's not very fluffy either. And I'm just going to kind of like carefully window wash over this, and I'm just grabbing from above this like really sharp line and pulling up rather than going on either side of that line. And yeah, I'm just like really buffing that out. I mean, this is so pretty. So for my lid, I'm gonna use Kosas Cosmetics 10 second eyeshadow in Astronaut. The reason I do Midnight after is because lighter colors love picking up darker pigments, so I don't want to like accidentally grab some of that and like spread it around. And also, if I feel like I wasn't able to stay like perfectly within this shape or that line gets a little muddy, just going back with the Midnight afterwards gives it just a touch of definition again. So pretty. And then I'm gonna pull this into just this inner corner as well. Now Midnight, since this is like all dried up, very, very light. I'm not getting much on this little eyeliner brush at all. Getting some of the initial pigment off on my hand as well. Loving that, guys. so pretty. So I'm gonna go white on my lower lash line. So I'm gonna use the Zuzu Luxe Eye Defining Pencil in Snow. I love this because it is very strong and has very good pigment. Just adds like a pop and makes your eyes look a bit bigger, which I really love. My PYT POV brow pencil. I always go a shade lighter than my actual hair so that it's more just filling in than like drawing a whole new eyebrow on. I already have pretty thick brows, so I don't want like too much extra pigment. I'm more just helping like create a shadow. I think onto mascara. I'm so excited to try this Honest Beauty volumizing mascara. I have heard nothing but good things. My only concern as of right now is I do know since it has both the primer and the mascara in one, it seems like it might not be as much product potentially, even though it's, I mean, it's like $18, which is a little better than most mascaras, but if I'm not gonna get as much product, then that's like still kind of expensive. The pink end here is the primer. Goes on very clear. I can tell that definitely builds up your lashes like immediately. Okay, got my primer on. I love the feel of this bottle. The matte finish on it is just really nice in your hand. Oh, whoa. I was expecting this to be the cap. Yeah, that's not much mascara, guys. It's a little expensive. It's a stiff silicone brush, which I do like. Yeah, guys, this mascara is pretty legit. I mean, it wants to clump up a touch. And this might sound weird, but it really curls your lashes, and I sometimes like my lashes to be a bit straighter. Just kind of like stick up rather than like curl up. But it is very, like, both volumizing and lengthening. It's very nice. Wow, guys, that mascara is amazing. I just got in my own little world because I'm not used to doing mascara on camera yet. Very big fan of that. And then last up, loving this look. I keep looking over at like my live play screen, and I'm really enjoying this. Bare Minerals, brand that some things are definitely clean and some things aren't so clean. Their lipsticks are typically pretty good. I'll give myself a touch of leeway with lipstick sometimes. I'm definitely trying to clean it up, but if I just like need a really good color and I just want to go find it in person, Bare Minerals is one of my only options. It's like a nice little tube like this. And this is a beautiful kind of like peachy nude. And it's so creamy, but even like putting these on the back of my hand yesterday, I could not like get them off super easily. I mean, it's so pretty. Thank you guys for joining along with this little fun tutorial. I think this cut crease turned out so well. So I love laying in bed for an hour watching makeup tutorials in the morning. I mean, why not? And yeah, please hit subscribe, like, comment, share. It means the world to me. Check out some of my other videos. Alt Beauty Spa on all platforms, Instagram, Pinterest, YouTube, TikTok. I will either link products down below here or give you a link to my website to find the products used. Thanks, guys. Have a great day, and please join in for more videos.